Ljubljana feels small. It is, with only about 250,000 people. But it's by far the country's largest city, its cultural capital, and a charming place to kick off any Slovenian trip.
A fortress has kept Ljubljana's hill since Roman times. As if turning its back on its hard-fought history, the city playfully straddles its sleepy river. Ljubljana is laid back, the kind of place where crumbling buildings seem elegantly atmospheric rather than shoddy. In its relaxed pedestrian center, it seems all roads lead to the main square. Fancy facades and whimsical bridges ornament daily life with a Slovenian twist. Centuries of rule from Vienna under the German-speaking Habsburgs seems to have both inspired an appreciation of the good life and strengthened the local spirit. The statue of Franca Prešeren, Slovenia's greatest poet, reminds locals that their language and culture are both distinct and worthy of pride. The Triple Bridge, where the town square joins the river, is both a popular meeting place and a beloved symbol of the city.
The bridge seems almost Venetian. That's because the architect recognized that Ljubljana is midway between Venice and Vienna, and the city itself was, and still is, a bridge between the Italian and the Germanic worlds.
The riverfront market is a hive of activity, where big city Slovenes enjoy buying directly from the farmer. Over time, shoppers develop friendships with their favorite producers. In this tiny country, it seems like everybody knows each other. Some farmers still use wooden carts to bring veggies in from their garden patches. The market is a perfect opportunity to connect with the locals.
Dobar dan.
Dobar dan.
Cherries?
Yes.
Half kilo. How do you say half kilo?
Pol kila.
This is your farm?
Our farm, yes. They are fresh.
Yes, they're very good.
These scales allow buyers to immediately double-check the arithmetic, just in case.
Habsburg days left locals with the old saying, trust is good, control is better. Half a kilo, just right.
The market's picturesque colonnade is designed to link the town and the river. It feels made to order for conviviality, enjoying a drink or observing the market action. Nearby, vintners proudly share their wines. These wines from the northeast of Slovenia are considered some of the country's best. Perhaps Ljubljana's single best activity is simply strolling the riverfront promenade and sitting in an outdoor cafe to watch the stylish Slovenes strut their stuff. As home to the country's main university, youthful Ljubljana is busy with students. An earthquake leveled the city in 1895. It was rebuilt in the Art Nouveau and Art Deco styles so popular in Vienna, the empire's capital at the time. Ljubljana remains a treasure trove of engaging architecture. This striking building was designed by an ambitious local architect, hoping to forge a uniquely Slovenian style.
But the big name in local architecture and urban design is Joža Plečnik. Like Gaudi-shaped Barcelona and Bernini-shaped Rome, Plečnik shaped Ljubljana. He lived in the early 20th century, studied in Vienna, made his name in Prague, and had his greatest impact right here in his hometown.
Prolific Plečnik essentially remodeled his hometown with his distinctive classical meets modern style. Along with the Triple Bridge and the Market Colonnade, Plečnik's brilliance for urban design, the ability to connect Ljubljanans to their city and river, is evident in his Cobbler's Bridge. Because he loved his town, walked to work each day, and had to live with what he designed, Plečnik was particularly thoughtful about incorporating aesthetics, nature, and people's needs into his work. The house of Ljubljana's favorite son is on an unassuming street. But behind the gate, in his garden, the creative world of Plečnik opens up. Guides passionate about his work give meaning to his home.
So this is Plečnik's room, where he worked and he slept here.
So his bed right next to his work table?
Yes, absolutely.
And a single bed, was he never married?
No, he was married to the architecture. But on the other hand, you have here a gilded sculpture on the top of the ceiling. Ooh. Some kind of a muse, you know. But if you look all around, you will see there are many, many personal objects. His glasses, or for example, his hat. He was famous by that hat, he was always wearing it and always dressed in black.
So Plečnik is very important to the Slovenian people.
Absolutely. He left such a strong mark, not only in Vienna and Prague, but definitely in Ljubljana, because all the land axes and river axes are designed by Plečnik.
And his heritage lives on today as the people enjoy his city.
That's the most important. All the bridges are crowded, you know, and their architecture really lives, even nowadays.
If this city works for its people and fits their character, it's at least in part thanks to Joža Plečnik.